The Red Special book is something which has been on the cards for years, and I actually made a start with another co-author, I think 20 years ago. So we had some bits and pieces kind of gathered together for it. But I have so many priorities in my life. I kept saying, well, I can't do this. I want to do my stereoscopy book. I want to do this astronomy book. I want to do Diableries. And so there was no room for the Red Special. What happened was, Pete Malandrone and Greg Brooks, Richard Gray, people who work in our structure, brought in this chap who's a writer from a music magazine, and they said, we're going to do it for you, Brian. We're going to write the book, and then you can go in and do whatever you want, but we will do the structure for you, and we'll move it along, and we'll have it out next year. So I went, yeah, okay, guys. Thinking it was going to be hard for them, but they did a magnificent job. So, and what they did was interview me. They set up me in a mock-up of my dad's workshop, and we looked at all the tools that I'd use in the making of the guitar, which is quite an emotional thing for me. It was like being back in my dad's little spare bedroom that he used. And I worked with my dad for 2 years on that guitar, just with hand tools and a little bit of ingenuity and experimentation. So they got all the information out of me and then wrote the book. And I only came in at the 11th hour and did my thing. You know, that seems to be a lot of what I do these days. I do a lot of editing of what other people do. And it works very well for me because I get a sort of overview and I can translate it into something which hopefully makes a coherent whole. So the book went out quickly. And sometimes things that happen quickly are the better for it. So suddenly I was holding this book in my hand and I thought, yeah, this really was worth it. And they were right to push me because given my own speed that I work, it would have been so far down the priority list, it would have been another 10 years. So I really like the Red Special book. It's got fantastic pictures in. Richard Gray found all these things in my archives, which I'd forgotten about, like me when I'd first made a guitar, playing it when it had no strings on. Making the pickups, you know, I used to wind my own pickups and stuff, and marking out the fretboard, making the fret wire, making the tremolo. The tremolo was my own design, which was very innovative in those days. Nobody really had a tremolo that rocked on a knife edge in those days. Nobody had little rollers on the bridge so that there would be no friction on the bridge, so that the guitar would return to tune once the whammy bar had been buttoned down. Anyway, the book's there, and I'm very happy. The book is called The Red Special, I think. Brian May's Red Special. And of all the books that I've put out, and there have been a few in recent times, this seems to be the one that people latch onto and really, it seems to make them smile.